With as much whooping and hollering and rowdiness as you can muster, please join me in welcoming Halden Wofford and Bonnie Sims.
Alyssa first contacted me about maybe, you know, talking to Fem Co. We all agreed, oh, country music duets, that would be fun. I was like, ah, yeah, there's tons written about country music duets. I'm just going to go and check it out, you know, in the academic presses. Nothing. You would think there'd be stacks of books about the subject, you know, gender roles, biases, signifiers, deconstructed algorithms about harmony and all that kind of crap, but there ain't.
But I've forgotten more.
So, I Forgot More Than You'll Ever Know About Him is another interesting type of song. It's the Keep Him, He's a Loser song. Sadly, Betty Jack Davis, the year of that song, was killed in a car accident. Skeeter Davis, her real name was Mary Frances Pinnock. She continued her career, and she sang harmony with herself. This is actually very interesting because this is the beginning of multi-track recording, and Chet Atkins had her sing with herself. And now you have all these country singers who are singing with dead people. It's like Tupac at Coachella appearing on the stage. I'm like, it's weird.
Probably my favorite duo in country music history.
And George Jones, they are sort of like the archetypal country voices coming together. And they had a tabloid romance. They were married. George was a severe alcoholic cocaine addict and abusive. And they've split up. And then they got back together again. And they would sing about getting back together again. But shortly after they started recording together was when she put out 1968 Stand By Your Man, which 1968 is the year of the Tet Offensive, My Life, Martin Luther King, Bobby Kennedy's assassination. So she put out Stand By Your Man, and kabam! It was as if the entire history of country music had lined up behind her to be on the wrong side of events. And she got so much criticism that she went to her grave defending that song.
So I was really impressed last year with Ashley Monroe's new album, and she continues the great tradition with Blake Shelton singing the song I Ain't Porter and You Ain't Dolly. Do you know that song?
This one?
Yeah. You ain't Porter. I mean, you ain't Dolly.
Oh, and you ain't Porter.
She's a little bit fuller.
Yeah, but you're a whole lot shorter.
Let's dance all night and fill the jukebox full of quarters.
Quarter. You ain't Dolly.
I'm a Kacey Musgraves fan, and part of the reason I really like her is because she sings songs that sort of critique country culture, I guess, sort of thing, and she's a big feminist, and I really like her a lot. And I was just wondering if there were any examples in the historical sort of scene that exemplified someone who was also critiquing their own culture that they came from, sort of thing.
I guess like that, like Harper Valley PTA, that's a huge critique of like the uptight hypocrites of the, you know, the Christian right PTA culture.
A lot of things changed in Nashville and a lot of attitudes about the way of making music as well as attitudes about the culture around country music changed when Dylan came in because it kind of blew the doors open on a lot of that, and that's where a lot of singers kind of expanded their consciousness.
I think we have time for one more question.
One more
or one more song, you think?
We got one more.
Lord's burning rain.
so much.